This collection video is sponsored by Snups.
Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And welcome to another collection video.
Yeah.
This is another throwback collection
it
video.
Is.
We did our Do You Remember Squinkies video a few weeks ago. And I thought it'd be fun to revisit Vinylmations. Now, Vinylmations for us are kind of like, we don't really consider ourselves Vinylmation collectors per se, but we've accumulated like a ridiculous amount of Vinylmations.
This is not all of them.
No, no. This is just some random ones we brought out for backdrop of the video.
Right.
So 2018, actually, believe it or not, is the 10th anniversary of Vinylmations. They kind of winded down quite a bit at Disney. They're not as big as they used to be because they used to have, like, trading nights. Mm-hmm. That was a big thing when they first came out. You know, you're supposed to get them and then trade them.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't do that anymore. Like, the big D Street stores that were all about Vinylmations have been all rethemed to Star Wars now and Marvel. But, you know, between Disney outlet stores and buying characters that we really like, buying commemorative ones, finding bags at thrift stores.
Or just buying a couple here or there to open for a blind bag video when we were, like, at the parks.
And then, you know, some of our friends have given us, like, bags of ones that they didn't really care for. We've given them all a home.
Yeah. So now we have a lot. And we're not even collectors.
Yeah, I started a shelf on Snups. Mm-hmm. By the way, Snups is the collector's app. We've mentioned it quite a few times on this channel.
We have.
I started a shelf for Vinylmations. I'm not even done yet, and there's already 60 characters on there.
Mm-hmm.
And I still have a bunch more to add. It's ridiculous.
So we thought in this video, other than kind of showing what kinds we have, we thought we would show off 5 of the Vinylmations that we have no idea why we have them.
Yeah, this is going to be the top 10 weirdest Vinylmations in our collection. Where we look at our shelf of Vinylmations, like, oh, there's Baymax. It's like, okay, and yeah, I remember getting Tron and, you know, Aladdin. I remember Aladdin was like one of the very first ones we got on one of our very first trips as a couple to Disney World. And like, oh, DuckTales and Mickey. But then you like come across like someone like, yeah. Like, I know it's the witch from Brave, but...
Right. But it's like, what is that?
So, Ben has picked out 5, and I've picked out 5. So let's go through them, have a couple laughs, and then you down in the comments, let us know if you have any, like, weird collections that you've accumulated.
Yeah.
Or if there are some weird Vinylmations that we've missed.
Yeah, and you can also take a picture and send it to us on Snups.
Yeah, share it with us.
Private message or on a collection shelf board. So... let us know what you guys have for Vinylmations, if you have any. Do you want to show off one of yours, and then I'll show off one of mine?
Sure.
Okay.
So the first one I grabbed off the shelf, I'm not even sure where we got him, but if you have not seen this cartoon, this Vinylmation would make no sense whatsoever. What do you think that is?
It looks like Pluto with a, like, he can't breathe.
Well, this is based on a 1949 cartoon called Pluto's Sweater, where Minnie has made a sweater for Pluto, and Pluto like chases the cat and lands in a tub of water, and the sweater shrinks on his head. So he goes through the entire cartoon with this shrunken sweater on his head, and like the sleeves are on his ears. But if you're just looking at Vinylmations on the shelf, you're like, what is that?
It looked like Pluto was choking. So that one is your first one. Mine, I think I'm gonna grab this one, based off from a Mickey Mouse cartoon series. This is Goofy, Ghoul Friend, and it's basically Goofy as a zombie. Now, I don't think I have seen this. So I would not recognize Goofy as a zombie, but there he is. He has bones sticking out of his nose and out of his feet, and you can see the bones in his arms. And so that is my weird pick. And the ears, there's flies buzzing around his face.
Now, most Vinylmations were in blind boxes, so you didn't really have a pick of what characters you wanted. I know some hardcore fans would figure out the layout of cases. But that never really worked for us. Because I think by the time we got to them, like, the employees had just, like, shuffled a bunch of random boxes together.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, even though you were, like, hoping to get you know, I don't know, flounder, you'd end up getting random fish number 3.
Right. Okay, what's your next top weirdest?
My next one is from the movie 101 Dalmatians. And this came later in the life of Vinylmation, mm-hmm. where they were adding like gimmicks, like translucent bodies. Mm-hmm. Because all of them were shaped like Mickey Mouse.
Mm-hmm.
But later on, they started adding like long neck pieces. That worked for like the Maleficent dragon.
Right.
But here's Roger Radcliffe, the owner from 101 Dalmatians. He still has the little stubby Mickey body, but now he has a freakishly long neck. Like I said, that worked for a dragon,
mm-hmm.
but it's kind of terrifying when you put it on a human.
I understand what they were going for.
Okay, Ben's next weird Vinylmation pick.
This one isn't really weird. It's more of a, I don't know why we have it, Vinylmation, because we don't collect anything Phineas and Ferb. Really, we don't watch it. We don't really, you know, follow it. We've picked up a couple things, you know, just because they were blind bags and they showed up. But and this would be one of them.
That's Phineas and Ferb's sister,
Candace.
I wanted to call her Cadence, but it's Candace.
And she's obviously thinking of her crush over here. I don't know his name. And it's cute. I like it. It's cute, but it's just kind of one of those things like, why do we have this?
I know exactly why we have it. Because remember that there was used to be like a $5 store in downtown Disney, and they'd have those grab bags of like assorted random stuff.
This was in one of those.
Either that or it was in one of Jenna's, and we just ended up adopting Candace. Oh, what's Candace's boyfriend's name? Let us know down in the comments.
Yeah, let us know. We're not very
okay.
Good.
The next one you're going to see pop up quite a bit because we don't know why we have so many. They must have been an outlet sale or something.
Mm-hmm.
These are the Urban Redo series,
right.
Series 2. And when you think of Disney, you think of Mickey Mouse, you think of a
mime-wearing underwear.
Mime wearing a mask, making a kissy face, having heart ears, and a little, like, Zorro hat. This one probably should have been my top one.
Probably.
I should have ended with this one. Because I think this, hands down, Ben wanted to pick this one, but I grabbed it first.
That one and one of your other ones I wanted to grab, but he grabbed them first.
Okay, this may have been... I should have ended on this one, because I don't think we're going to be able to top kissy underwear guy in Vinylmation form.
And the rest of mine are also from the Urban series. This is another one. It's a crocodile? Maybe it's an alligator?
No, I think
it's Medusa?
I think it's like a snake monster.
I have no idea. There's snakes all over its head. It has a snake tongue, so yeah, I guess it's not a crocodile. I don't know. It has, you know, some bronze cuffs for its arms and a bracelet. I don't know what this is. And it's definitely not something I think of when I think of Mickey Mouse, except for maybe Indiana Jones ride. That's about it.
There must have been a special on these things. So it's usually the ones that we tended to buy were, you know, oh, the princesses or Mickey in astronaut costumes. Things like that. Now, earlier we said, you know, how they're blind boxes and how you'd always hope, okay, I hope we get Ariel.
Mm-hmm.
So they did an Alice in Wonderland series.
Right.
So many great characters in Alice in Wonderland. You get a blind box, so I hope I get Alice or the Mad Hatter or the Queen of Hearts. No, there's the hedgehog that the Queen of Hearts uses as a croquet ball.
Yeah, because that's the person you want to get. Well, I mean, maybe there are some fans of them, but...
And knowing Disney, these probably came like 5 per case.
Probably.
So, yeah, here's the Alice in Wonderland hedgehog.
He's cute, but I wouldn't know that's what he was. You know what I mean? Like, just looking at him, I wouldn't know that's who he was.
He would be in the most likely you'd want to trade for somebody
else.
Yeah. He's the most likely to disappoint you when you open up an Alice in Wonderland blind box at Disney World.
Yep.
That's why he's making that face. He's so depressed.
He's like, oh, nobody wants me.
Nobody wants me.
All I'm good for is to be a croquet ball.
Okay, next up.
Next up is from the Urban Redo Series 2 is this woolly mammoth.
Well, he looks a little cute.
He's very cute. It's just, I mean... Or is he like is he a woolly mammoth or is he supposed to be like a heffalumphalum?
Well, I see the tusks.
So, I don't know. It's It's strange. It's just not, like, just because they're weird doesn't mean they're not cute. It's just not what I think of when I think of Disney.
And when we look at our shelf, it's like, why do
it stands
we have,
out.
Why do we
yeah.
have this?
Why do we have this guy?
Vinylmations, definitely not as prominent as they used to be. I think they still come out with one or two series a year, usually around like a Star Wars or Marvel movie. Mm-hmm. But it used to be, you go to Disney and there'd be hundreds of mm-hmm. these things. And like
walls of them.
Yeah, there'd be stations where you could trade with a cast member. We never did that because after paying, you know, $10, $13 for one of these buggers, it's like,
I'm keeping it.
Okay. Next up, we have the Creepy Clown.
That was another one I was going to pick.
I mean, this makes sense in the context of a series called Under the Big Top.
Right.
But when you're looking at a series of DuckTales and Beauty and the right. Beast and Peter Pan and NC, it's me, Creepy Clown. It's like, ah! And we still have them because, you know, it's not like they have much value on eBay. Right. So it's just like, oh, we'll add it to the shelf with all these other mm-hmm. guys.
I believe that one was gifted to us from someone else.
Yeah, some of our friends have given us bags of one set. These are like the Island of Misfit Vinylmations.
It is.
Because I don't think we have a full set of anything. Maybe Jungle Book because we found a case for cheap.
Yeah, I think there are very few.
But for the most part, it's just like, oh, we have a couple from this series and a couple from that series. Oops. So are you going to pick on Urban Redo again?
I am. This is my last one. It's not bad. It's just...
I mean, I get it because, you know, especially in the early days of vinyl figures like this, you know, that was the thing. You know, you take a generic shape and repaint it like street art style.
Right. So this is a radio. It has the tuning knob, the volume knob. On the back, it has the 9-volt battery compartment, has the speakers, and it is transistors on the front. It's like a speaker. It kind of reminds me of like a basketball playing radio.
It looks like Mickey wearing some terrifying mask.
It's Mickey on Halloween dressed up as a steampunk horror killer. So anyway, this is another one. It's just, it's not bad. It's not ugly. It's not, you know, it's not scary. It's just
weird.
So that is my last one. I'll put it over here to balance things out.
One thing I do like about the randomness of our Vinylmation collection is that, you know, looking at them reminds me like where we get it. You know, some of them I ask like, where or why do we have it? But it's like, there used to be commemorative ones, like from the D23 expos, like the earlier ones. Like this was, I think this was 2011, maybe 2013.
Yeah, it was an early one.
Yeah, this was 2013, so this must have been 2011. Mm-hmm. And then they haven't done them since, unfortunately. And then like they did a series for Disneyland's
attractions.
Yeah, Disneyland 60th. I don't remember.
Yeah, and it was like different attractions throughout the park. And then, you know, obviously for the new movies that are coming out, and, you know, they have a lot of cool things.
Like, I remember a couple years ago when Teagan was super young, remember we were in a hotel room and did a quick little video, and we opened the astronaut ones?
Mm-hmm.
Just things like that, but I don't know how much longer Vinylmation will be around, because they've discontinued a lot. They kind of moved on to Tsum Tsums.
Right.
I think a couple of things. I think the price got to a point where nobody wanted to collect a set.
Yeah, it was. They got up to like $17 a piece or something
some
close
of them,
like that.
Some of them, I think, I want to say like $13.99, $14.99 just for one blind box. And then there are so many other blind boxes out now that it's a hard sell. I mean,
and then there could be like 13 or 14 in a set, you know. So that's a pretty expensive collection, you know.
And nobody really traded them anymore, especially in the parks.
Right.
Because they eventually showed up at Disney stores. Remember, we were in New York, and we found the Zootopia ones. Mm-hmm. And then again, we only bought like a couple because they were so expensive.
Right.
Gradually, over time, they started marking them more as collectibles than like, oh, buy a couple and trade them through Disney World. If you're around Disney World and know if they still make a lot of Vinylmations, let us know. So there we go, a look back at our weird collection of Vinylmations, our random collection of Vinylmations.
Yeah.
Let us know what you thought down in the comments. If you have any weird collections, random Vinylmations, We'd love to see them on our Snups group.
Right, so definitely share them with us on Snups. Go over, check that out. There's a link down in the description on how to get Snups as an app, and you can also use it on the desktop on a computer, so you don't need to have an app. You can use it on the computer website. There'll be a link to that as well.
Yeah, check out our page. We have a bunch of our Disney collections up there. The app is really handy. I know we've mentioned it over and over again. We love being out and about, especially if you collect a lot of blind box type stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't remember which ones you have.
Especially if you have sporadic collections like this. You know, it's a great way to be like, oh, do we have that one? Maybe.
So check out some of our Disney collectibles. And if you're a My Little Pony fan, we also moderate a My Little Pony collectors group on Snups as well.
Yeah, and you can share your collections over there and see what other people have and see things that you may not have seen before.
Thanks again for Snups for sponsoring this video, and we'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.